But you have been linked to some of the most beautiful women.
Well, it's nice to hear. Nicer if it was true. As soon as Ghazi gets over, I get into Baahubali, into the war. Yeah. I don't think anyone will want to marry me in that avatar.
A lot of people are saying you're going to do Bala's next film. You heard the story from Mr. Bala?
Yeah, I heard the story from Mr. Bala. I'm also working with Amir. If you see even post Baahubali, a film like Srimathru did very well.
Maybe.
Which is a very unlike a star film.
Okay.
So we have a big set of the Indian submarine, INS S-21, and then obviously there's PNS Ghazi that we put up.
Okay.
I'm a familiar face.
Yeah.
He looked twice. He said, Baahubali, he watched a pirated version of the Tamil film with Malay subtitles.
Wow! And why is it only releasing in Tamil?
See, again, this is a very region-centric film.
Rana, welcome to Red Carpet.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Are you tensed about the release of Bangalore Naatkal?
Not tense. Tensed is not the word I'll use, because there's some comfort of doing a remake is, you know, there's a part of the country that's seen the film and have really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
So what we've done is obviously made it better, and we've had a director like Bhaskar who's almost a pioneer in this kind of cinema, if you've seen his earlier films.
Yeah, that soft romantic movies.
Yeah, whether it's Bammarillu, whether it's Paragu, they're films in his genre.
Mm.
And me being a part of the film, I know exactly what he's done.
Mm.
He's made it a more vibrant and a sharper film.
The Nivin Pauly role also is supposed to be good.
No, all three are fantastic roles. It's just that, see, sometimes you get connected to something when you watch it.
Ah.
And when I saw Shivdas's role that was originally played by Fahad, the one I played now in Tamil.
Yeah. But isn't that a bit serious of role? It's not your usual...
More than serious, it's like this. See, now, what is this film? It's a film that's a slice of life.
No.
And when I saw that role, that was the most rounded character in the film.
Yeah.
So it's what happens in your past and or events in your past shape you as a human being today.
Mm.
And that's exactly what this role is. And
so that role excited you?
That completely completed it.
And why is it only releasing in Tamil?
See, again, this is a very region-centric film. Now, this is a tale of a bunch of cousins from Vellore who want to go to Bangalore. Now, that wouldn't work in Telugu.
Okay.
You need to find another town. You need to find dynamics of that town.
Yeah.
You need to find passions for people like that who want to go to another city.
Hmm.
See, a lot of smaller towns in Tamil Nadu, actually, Bangalore is closer than Chennai is to them.
Yeah.
And Bangalore for them is where they want to be. And Chennai is actually...
Yeah, it's a dream city.
It's a dream city. Now, if you have to set it up in Andhra, we need to find towns that are closer to Bangalore.
Okay.
So that's, I mean, again, you have to get into the regional dynamics of the film.
Okay.
I mean, we love to, we're going to for sure do it again.
But you are an original Chennai boy, you're born and brought up in Chennai.
Yes.
So do you speak Tamil in this film or?
Of course I speak Tamil in the film.
Did you dub for yourself?
I didn't dub for it because the reason is I'm still accented Telugu.
Okay.
See, I speak Tamil reasonably well, I converse quite well. That was the first language that I grew up learning.
Yeah.
But it's been 25 years in Hyderabad.
Yeah.
Sorry, 22 years in Hyderabad now. Yeah. So there's a heavy Telugu accent that will that will trickle down in this. But so yeah, hopefully in a year from now I'll continue dubbing.
Yeah, your Baahubali has done extraordinary business in Tamil Nadu.
Yes.
So they'll, I mean, depending on you a lot to get that opening, the all crucial opening.
Yes.
What do you feel? I mean, are you going to do straight Tamil films hereafter?
I've been wanting to do straight Tamil films, I think, from the time I started acting in movies. I'm sure you would have heard in news when I was supposed to do a film at Selva at some point.
Yeah, at the Selva, you were supposed
to. At some point. Just that things just never fell in place.
Actually, Mr. Selvaraghavan had signed you for a...
We were supposed to do a film which just didn't happen because of many, many things that came in between. And then I started doing Hindi films. So then that happened faster than Tamil. My first film was actually produced by AVM. A leader was produced by AVM Cinemas, and I was supposed to do a film for them after. So things just didn't materialize, and then I guess the right film comes
your way. AVM and your grandfather's relationship made you give you that big break with leader. But why did you do a straight Tamil film?
Well, there you go. I guess it's the right time for the right film. And Baahubali, originally being a Telugu film, also shot in Tamil, has broken barriers right now. People in Tamil Nadu relate to that film or take that film as a straight Tamil film. And I'm sure Baahubali 2 will be much bigger than what it was, what part 1 did.
Are the producers and the director is hiding you from the Tamil version because you're not there much in the trailer, see, because it's all Arya and
see,
Bobby.
And also, see, that's also how the film plays out.
Okay.
Now if you see
that mystery character.
Yeah, see, it doesn't start like a story.
Hmm.
It starts like now there are. It's a tale of three cousins who believe that Bangalore is their dream city, and everything beautiful will happen from then on.
Hmm.
And that's when I enter their lives, and things change.
Hmm.
So it's a gradual entry into the film,
okay.
And eventually you will realize why this man is like this. So that's the journey that one needs to follow.
Okay, and you have followed exactly the Fahad character, or the director has made changes.
See, what we've done to Fahad, the present piece of Fahad, I've almost tried to pick as much as Fahad, what Fahad did. With slight mind, so obviously I don't look the same. I'm twice as big as Fahad.
Yeah,
physically.
At some time, so you're saying at some point, will you remake that film in Telugu?
I want to do it now. See, again, it's a very interesting film. It's a very tricky film to cast. I'm glad it fell in place. So I'm hoping when we do it in Telugu, also we have that right mixture that we can get.
Bangalore போறதுக்கு ஒரு பஸ் டிக்கெட் எடுத்தா போதும். அதுக்கு போய் யாராவது கல்யாணம் பண்ணிப்பாங்களா?
கலாச்சாரம்னா நம்ம தமிழ்நாடு தான.
How's your romantic life going? They picturize you as the most romantic man in India.
And I think you know how my last 1 week, 10 days have been. I have been in Dubai, in Vizag, in Malaysia, now back in Hyderabad.
Yeah.
And that's how my entire year is.
Yeah.
So what others paint me to be, I really am not.
But the Tamil plus make you out to be sort of a Casanova.
That's the best thing, when you're not there, you can write anything about the guy. So I guess Bombay bear the brunt of, I bear the brunt of it in Bombay.
But you have been linked to some of the most beautiful women.
Well, it's nice to hear. Nicer if it was true. But no, see I've never hid my life from anything.
You're an open book.
I'm an open book. I have it. See, what I've made a conscious choice in my life is, now I know many actors before they were an actor and after. Their lives changed dramatically. Whether it's going out to places or living social lives or... So I just said, I'm going to stick and just do my thing as it is.
Okay.
And so I'm the only guy you see out in a coffee shop, you'll see out on the road eating food. You will see...
Pubbing.
Yeah, anything. I'm saying, so I just didn't change my life.
Yeah.
And I guess that's so I get these... I'm the fastest target to be written about.
Okay. How do you cope up with these kind of... when people... I mean, off the tangent.
I have a very basic logic which my grandfather told me many years ago. What others think of you is their problem, not yours.
Wow!
And I live it like that.
Okay,
so you live that. If that's their assumption of me, keep it.
Okay.
Good for you.
You don't get into any nakras or fights.
I mean, it's pointless. No?
Yeah.
There are other important things to do.
Do in life.
Yeah.
Okay. And now, would you be getting married sometime? Or will you go for a conventional marriage?
Well, I should get married at some point, I think.
Yeah.
I'm not getting any younger. But I guess when the time is right, it'll happen. I mean, I don't want to question it of as to how and why and in which format. But right now, I'm married to a bunch of movies. I'm married to a Baahubali. I'm married to a Ghazi. I'm banging to a
Bangalore. So, no marriage in 2016?
That's guaranteed, that's for sure. Because as soon as Ghazi gets over, I get into Baahubali, into the war. Yeah. I don't think anyone will want to marry me in that avatar.
A lot of people are saying you're going to do Bala's next film.
Yes, I've been asked. It's a great story.
You heard the story from Mr. Bala?
Yeah, I heard the story from Mr. Bala. I have a very interesting lineup of films, actually. There's Bala's first film, which is... He's a filmmaker that I've actually grown up worshipping more than learning. Because I think he's one of the most original filmmakers this country has ever produced. And I'm very excited and looking forward to working with him. I'm also working with Amir.
But both these guys are Tamil directors, pure Tamil directors. So how will you...
So I'm doing pure Tamil films. See, there you go, my... your first question is answered.
Okay, we are doing a
Pakka Tamil. Yeah, pure Tamil film, yes.
Okay. And any pure Telugu movie in the...
Leader 2. Yes, sir.
The same team which was...
Same team is coming back 5 years later.
Baahubali also, end of this.
Yeah, end of this.
But Baahubali has given you that national reach.
Completely. I mean, it's given... It's actually put everybody, including Telugu cinema itself, on a world map.
And overseas, the Telugu cinema's footprints are now very strong.
Getting bigger and bigger in places like America and all that. So, in fact, I was there yesterday in Malaysia and I got into a cab. And the first day, the cab driver looked at me, he kept looking back because he looked like I'm a familiar face.
Yeah.
He looked twice, he said, Baahubali? I said, there you go. I said, perfect. And it's amazing, he watched a pirated version of the Tamil film with Malay subtitles.
Wow!
I said, it's unreal. Like, so, I guess that's the reach of that film.
We are on the sets of Rana's new film, Ghazi, talked about film on Indo-Pak War and how the submarine came in Vizag in 1971. Let's talk about Ghazi. It's a very important film for you.
Yes, a very important film for me, and it's a very important story to be told, which is more the reason why we jumped into this. Now, for me, it's another war film, but this time underwater. I heard of this incident many years ago. Because obviously I keep going to Vizag, coming back, you see remains of Ghazi in the water. We've heard these very brief tales. But then when Sankalp came and first narrated this story about 6-8 months ago, now it felt like a very important film to do. It was a thriller, it was a tale that happened in our land. It happened so close to us. So it's the original history is when in 1971 when the big Pakistan submarine called Ghazi came into the Vishakhapatnam waters. And how it was taken down. Now there's a conspiracy attached to that tale. It's a classified file. So the film lies somewhere between the conspiracy and the truth and what we have made of the truth.
Yeah, but how far do you think a film which is something different within the commercial format?
See, it's in a very commercial format because it's a war film. It's an India-Pakistan film. This tale originally happened just before the India-Pakistan war.
But it's not the typical Telugu film where there's romance and...
So it's not. Baahubali is also not a typical Telugu film.
Yeah.
It's a war film.
What's your comment whether it has worked or not?
See, now, I think, there is a large openness to newer cinema, which has been coming over the last couple of years. The standard star system kind of films haven't been working in the recent run. If you see even post-Baahubali, a film like Srimathru did very well, which is a very unlike a star film. It again falls in a very genre-specific zone, which is why the audience have taken to it.
Okay.
Now, if you see the previous year when there were a bunch of star... Sorry, this year, last year, when there were a bunch of star films that went in the standard song and dance mode in that regular typical commercial format, which the audience haven't received.
Because so you feel the audience have changed and they are ready to accept something different?
They just want newer cinema.
Okay.
They just want newer stuff. I mean, you've given this commercial format for the last 20 years. They're like, now give us something new. And I think we, and also many times it's not the film that fails, it's the budget that fails it. This is, Ghazi is being made in a very, very controlled budget as much as we can. We're shooting it in Hindi and Telugu. We're dubbing it in Tamil.
So it's you don't have any song or dance in there.
No, it's a thriller. It's a straight-on thriller. It's an India-Pakistan tale. It's the tale of camaraderie of Indian naval soldiers.
Tapsi is there?
Tapsi, yes. Tapsi plays a Bangladeshi refugee in the film. So also a very, very character-specific film.
And what about the villains and the
there again, we've taken many theatre actors in the film. Now, the primary cast in the film is K.K. Menon, who plays a very pivotal role. Atul Kulkarni, who plays a very pivotal role.
Okay,
So it's, and Tapsi obviously, and myself. So it's a tale of these actors.
Shut up! How are you preparing for this Ghazi role? Now we are near the swimming pool and you have a huge set.
See, one is, first there have been a lot of references that have been given to me even before we started. So Sankalp is a very, very detailed man, the man who wrote this film.
Okay. You have put up the set here as...
Yeah, right behind, yes, of course.
He's the submarine.
He is the submarine. So, that way it's a comfortable film to shoot because the next 3 months I am nowhere but in this one location.
Yeah.
There's nowhere else to go.
Okay.
So we have a big set of the Indian submarine, INS S-21, and then obviously there's PNS Ghazi that we put up.
Okay.
So there's two big submarines and we just go in it and shoot.
Yeah.
And what we've taken into detail is how commanders of 1971 were, because there were very, very educated backgrounds who actually went into the armies and the navies at that point. And one is my friends actually come from the naval backdrop. So there's some people who I've spoken to. Obviously, I can't give reference names for certain reasons, but there have been a lot of research.
You yourself are a diver, I'm told?
Yes, sir. I love the water, yes. Yes, I'm a diver. I have a professional diving license.
Oh!
Yes. So, I used to do a lot when I was younger, but now cinema has taken over things to do. But so that's been one, and large reference from films abroad. The Crimson Tide, I don't know if you've watched
it. Yeah, Crimson Tide, it's a fantastic movie.
Yeah, so my iPad right now has Crimson Tide, Hunt for Red October, U571, and that's the film I keep watching.
These are the references.
Yeah, fully.
Yeah.
And it's lovely that in the West they get to see so many films of that format, and I'm happy we're being the first here. Seatbelt up,